So we went and got groceries, and I also went and got a couple of craft supplies, and so there's still a few things I forgot to get after I got home, of course. I remember. That's how it goes. But yeah, I'm just gonna start showing you guys what we got, and some of it's the same stuff, but there's a lot of new things too, so I'm really excited. Let's get into it. First, I got some
milk with every meal, unless we just wanted water. And
Thousand Island. Peppery, that might help a little. I don't know. And my husband really likes ranch, and also I use it for carrots. I like to dip little baby carrots in it. This is a pretty big bottle. It's the light. Okay, next we got some vegetables. It's fresh and it's very creamy. That's an interesting sound. Spice it up other than just plain lettuce. And so I got a little thing of kale. It was like 79 cents. It's very pretty. I think kale looks really pretty. It's still kind of wet too. And I also just got a plain head of iceberg lettuce, which is probably the most unhealthy type of lettuce. I mean, it's not bad for you, but it's definitely not good for you, if that makes any sense. This is just iceberg, and it's not bad for you, but it's just mostly water. It's not very green. It's very light, and when it comes to vegetables or lettuce, it's like types of greens. The greener, the better, so. I'm used to eating this. Like when my family would make a salad, this was what they meant. And so I'm trying to kind of wean myself of only eating iceberg lettuce. So that's why I got just one instead of like two or three. Next up, we got some sweet potato waffle fries. My husband loves sweet potatoes now, like he's just recently found his love for them. I've always loved sweet potatoes, especially the French fries. They're so good. And I know, at least in the South, a lot of people like to put brown sugar or syrup on them. And I just think that that's pointless. Like, that just makes them unhealthy, because they're typically a healthy snack, like a sweet vegetable. And typically they're pretty good for you if you bake them. But I've never put syrup or brown sugar on mine. I like them plain. And my husband's recently found his love for sweet potato fries, so we got a couple of bags. Sweet potato waffle fries. It is the Kroger brand. taste better in waffle form. Last night I made salad ingredients where I took chicken and I started, sorry I changed my talking just because it's not making me run out of breath as easy, so I might switch between whispering and talking like this. I got this little pineapple slices. And I made chicken last night, and I shredded it up, and I cooked it in pineapple juice with pineapples like this, and put some honey over the chicken, and my husband loved it. It was simple, and it wasn't super bad for him, and so we just put that in our salad, and we had a salad dinner with our friends, so it was really fun, and it's really good, and he liked it, so I bought some more pineapple slices to do that again. It's also good with like pork, so if you like pork chops or pork loin or something, you can try it with this. It's really good. Next up, I got this Kroger brand queso blanco sauce. We tried it the other day with our taco salad that we made. We made it with deer meat because we ran out of hamburger meat, so, excuse me, I just sneezed, and it was really good, so we got another can. It's not the best for you, but it's gluten-free, so you can have it, and the taco salad was really good, so we're probably going to do that again, but with actual hamburger meat this time, and I got myself some flour tortillas, and he got some corn hard shell tortillas, so we're good to go. My husband's been really getting into honey roasted peanuts or any kind of roasted sea salt. And if you don't eat the whole freaking can at once, they're actually pretty good for you. And they're gluten-free, so he can have them. And I like them too, but I don't really... I go through habits of, like, not wanting to eat something for, like, a month or two after I've eaten a lot of it. Like these. Like, I had, like, two big cans of them like this. And this time I just didn't want any because I was just over it for a little while. I'll probably want some the next time we go shopping, but we'll see. I might eat a couple of his. It just depends on how I feel, my mood. Okay, next I got some more pinto beans. I got another can. We got another can of Bush's Honey Baked Beans. My husband loves these when we grill. Got some whole kernel corn. My husband loves corn. It's not like the best thing for you. It doesn't really digest well, but he likes it with most things, so I try to get a few cans here and there. Super sweet golden corn, whole kernel. It's about 3.5 servings, and he really likes it, so that's what we get sometimes. I like carrots better. I also got two cans of black-eyed peas. Bush's. I like Bush's brand. Now kiss. I'm ridiculous, you guys. These are really good. Like I said, with the cornbread. Try it out sometime. And I also got some sweet garden variety peas. These are really good. As a country girl, we had these all the time. My mom used to call them Martian boogers. Like, what is that? That's gross. I guess just to be funny and make me go, ew, as a kid, I guess. They're really good, and you don't need anything to go in them. Maybe a little salt and pepper. But they're naturally sweet, so they're really good. I recommend them if you've never tried them. And we used to pick peas all the time, and I kind of miss it. It's really rewarding to pick your own food. Next, we got my husband's socks. They are men's low-cut, 10 pairs, gilded socks. He doesn't really care what color he gets, but, excuse me, I usually try to recommend him getting half and half because you never know what you're going to have to go to and what you're going to have to wear. And so I feel like these are good for, you know, formal events or just going out running. So I usually recommend that he gets different colored ones because he used to only have white or black, and now he's got like a good 50-50 mixture of them. So yeah, just socks. And I found out something today. Women's socks are so much more expensive than men's socks, and they don't come in packs as big as this, which is a ripoff, and it sucks because I was trying to get a pair of socks, like a pack of socks like this, and I could not find them anywhere. Like, the most I could find was like four pairs, and it was $9. And I live in Mississippi, and our stuff is cheaper than up north. I know that for a fact. And so for me to pay almost $10 for four pairs of socks is ridiculous. And he paid like $5 for 10 pairs of socks. Now, how is that fair? Like, they weren't cute. They weren't like decorated or like a fancy material or therapy sock. No, they were exactly like these. They were the exact same material, the exact same kind, probably even the same brand. And they were twice the price. That's bullcrap. Yeah, women's stuff is so much more expensive. Why? Like, why is this? Someone tell me why. Maybe this is TMI, but we also got him a pair of underwear. I decided against the socks because I was refusing to pay $10 for 4 pairs of socks. So I'm probably just going to steal some of his or go buy some at like dirt cheap or something because I refuse to pay $10 for 4 pairs of freaking socks that aren't even cute. But yeah, we got him some boxer briefs, the Hanes brand, and they're pretty colors. And like I said, I also got me some flour tortillas for our taco night. I just got the cheapest brand I could find. It's a super soft, large burrito flour tortillas, Mission, world's best-selling tortilla. Woo, because they're cheap, probably. I think all tortillas taste the same if they're flour. I will say that the gluten-free tortillas, like soft shells, are disgusting, and they're like this big. Not worth it. Just get the hard shells. Just container, oily and acne. brown skin, so I think this is probably going to be the one that's best for me because I do have really oily skin and acne prone skin. So, and I didn't even break the seal inside here. I just opened the top. And it smells so strong, like it is so minty. Supplies and stuff, but I just found out that Michael's, the craft store, has 50% off coupon. love sketchbooks if you're ever looking for a really good one. It's great for everything. Like, I can do watercolor, crayons, pencils, charcoal, pastels, acrylic. It's great for everything. Like, you can always get, like, the specific pads for specific media, like acrylic or watercolor. But it's twice the price, and you can only really use it for one or two things because specific paper is usually not very good for other mediums. Just as a note from an artist. That's it for this shopping haul video. I hope you guys have enjoyed it. I actually enjoyed doing these, and